Hey folks, what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be watching what I think is an amazing part of a debate. I think this debate will go down in history. And in this debate, on the right here, you have Lawrence Krauss, the Woody Allen of atheism, and then you have the moderator all the way over here to the left, and then you have Dr. William Lane Craig in the middle. If you want to see a great debate, go to shotgunnow.net and you can see a debate where Dr. William Lane Craig defeats Christopher Hitchens in debate. Now in this debate, he defeats Lawrence Krauss. And what you're going to see here is, I think, absolutely remarkable. I've never seen this happen in a debate. The guy on the right, the atheist, he actually accuses Dr. Craig of misquoting. But then in the middle of the debate, Dr. Craig shows the actual quote, and it turns out that Krauss manipulated this quote dishonestly. And then he even admits that he manipulated it within the debate. And the crowd starts, when Craig's pointing this out, the crowd starts roaring because it's a epic gotcha moment where Dr. Craig shows really what I feel is the dishonesty of atheist Lawrence Krauss. Extremely dishonest. And watch this here. You can see Krauss is getting nervous because he starts to see that Craig has the actual quote, and they're quoting these scientists back and forth, and come to find out that Dr. Craig was being honest, of course, and Krauss was the one that manipulated the document. So watch this. This is just phenomenal that this atheist Lawrence Krauss would be caught red-handed, really being dishonest, when here he's accusing his Christian opponent of being dishonest, when it was the atheist Lawrence Krauss that got caught red-handed. Now, if you want to see the full debate, I'm going to play the clip right now, but if you want to see the full debate, go to shotgunnow.net and go to our videos area. Check this out. This is phenomenal. This is where you could see Krauss getting really nervous. And notice Craig's got it, Flanders. Let's bring up that slide that Krauss had, you know. Now watch how Krauss doesn't want to show the slide, and he's trying to basically back out of it, and you could even see Krauss start to be vividly shaken here. This is absolute hilarious because Krauss gets caught in a lie, but in front of all these people in this debate. Check it out.
I can go put it back up.
Yeah, while you're doing that, can I ask you a question about this while you're going?
Let's see if we need to put the slide up.
Notice he goes, well, let's see if we need to put the slide up. Notice he don't really want to put the slide up because Krauss is going to be shown to be a blatant liar. But let's continue.
So my question is whether there aren't models out there like Anthony Aguirre's steady state internal inflation models. Don't they just show that the implications of the theorem have got to be very limited?
Well, the point is, as Alex pointed out, look, first of all, this is a red herring in the first place. It's like, I'd like to sort of use Dr. Craig's argument, although now we're now on a first name basis, so I'll go and Bill.
Notice he's getting all friendly now. Before he was really rude, and he's trying to change the subject. He doesn't want to show the slide, but Craig's not going to let him get off the hook. And by the way, for you atheists that say that there is no beginning to the universe, in this next statement, Krauss admits that, yes, there's more evidence for the universe having a beginning. So I think we can put that to rest, guys. It's time that we, you know, catch up with what the Bible has said all along. You know, the Bible had said all along that the universe had a beginning, and it's good to see that science is now catching up with the truth of the Bible. Do you know that years and years and years in the past, atheists believed that the universe was eternal and uncaused? These were atheist scientists that believed this. Yet the Bible said clearly that the universe had a beginning, and Christians were being ridiculed for believing that the universe had a beginning, but now it is the atheists that have egg on their face, and Christians have been vindicated, and the Bible has been proven true that the universe does have a beginning, which Krauss will back up here also. Even Krauss, who just obviously hates God. When you go to see this video at shotcanal.net in our videos area, you'll see that Krauss really just hates God. But watch this. This is really embarrassing for Lawrence Krauss. Caught red-handed in a lie in the middle of this huge debate.
It doesn't matter whether the universe had a beginning or not. That's not a crucial point. So let me just point out that that's a red herring. As I said the first night, if I were going to guess, I would guess our universe had a beginning, namely space and time began. Okay, I guess that's the most likely part.
There it is.
But that doesn't.
He's admitting it had a beginning.
But you're absolutely right that there are tons of models, and whether you think they're better motivated or more poorly motivated, that involve a contracting phase and then an expanding phase. And in fact, Alex was talking about the fact that he has one, that there's one for the multiverse. And
now watch, Craig's going to say, "Well, let's see that quote."
Only as good as its assumptions. It assumes a classical space-time. We all know that when you go back early enough, you have to consider quantum gravity. By the way, we don't have a theory of quantum gravity. We don't know what's going to happen.
Notice Krauss is trying to change the subject. Craig's not going to forget about what the topic was.
Applicable at the time that really matters.
Watch.
Well, I'd like to see this,
this
private email.
Here it is.
Put up on the screen to see who has misquoted Vilenkin.
Oh my gosh, Krauss! I bet Krauss could die. I bet Krauss could die here. He's
quoting him. I generally find.
Okay, that's it, isn't it?
Okay.
Watch this. The crowd goes wild. Hold on a second. Notice it's cut off here. Okay, and Craig's going to talk about how the quote's cut. It's cut off. It's not the entire quote. So it is Krauss that is quote mining here and being a very dishonest atheist. He needs to be more of an honest atheist. But then again, morals are subjective to him. But watch this.
As good as its assumptions. The BGV theorem says that if the universe is on average expanding along a given world line, this world line cannot be extended or cannot be infinite to the past. A possible loophole is that there might be an epoch of contraction prior to the expansion.
Krauss look nervous to you? Krauss look a little bit nervous?
Chen. Now, the thing is, Lawrence, that in the very paper that I quoted from Alex Vilenkin last April, he shows specifically by name that the Aguirre and Grattan model and the Carolyn Chen model don't work.
He said you have to make an assumption about entropy. You have to make an assumption about the evolution of entropy at the point of minimum size. You have to make an assumption, which he would argue that they don't have any rationale for. That's not the same as saying that they're wrong.
Well, yes, it is. He argues that all of the evidence shows that the universe had a beginning, and that in these models...
I would agree all the evidence shows. Let's accept that fact. All the evidence suggests our universe had a beginning.
Now, this is where it hits the fan. And Krauss is just trying to talk over Craig because Craig's going to point out where Krauss manipulated the actual document here and it's not showing the full thing. And the crowd that at this time has been somewhat silent goes into a roar of laughter when Krauss is found out to be dishonest here. And Craig, in a brilliant move, shows the dishonesty of Lawrence Krauss. Here it goes. Now, it's going to take a while because Woody Allen over here on the right keeps droning on, and he's interrupting Craig, and Craig can't get to his point. And Krauss just doesn't want him to get to his point because Craig's going to expose Lawrence Krauss to the entire crowd as basically a charlatan. Watch this.
But we don't know. That's what I keep telling you. Knowing and suspecting are two vastly different things.
I'm never saying that this is known with certainty. This is a mischaracterization on your part. What I argue is that the premise is more probably true than false. And actually, you agree with me on that the universe began to exist. But I want to focus on this claim that I've somehow misrepresented Vilenkin.
Well, the key line is the last one, that the theorem breaks...
Now, notice Craig's trying to get him. Watch, we're going to get to that moment. Be patient, guys. And I apologize as Krauss keeps droning on and on. Krauss keeps trying to interrupt. And then finally, in about another minute, Craig finally makes his statement and the crowd erupts in laughter because Lawrence Krauss has been exposed as a charlatan, a dishonest person.
Now, wait a minute. Point where it really matters.
One at a time.
Now, there's okay. More here, because I noticed that at the end of this paragraph where the Carol Chan and Aguirre Grattan models are mentioned, that he specifically shows...
Because it was technical. He
specifically shows that these models cannot be past eternal and that they involve, therefore, a beginning of the universe,
Bill,
just like the
you
others.
You can do the math if you want. I'd love you to do it.
I couldn't help notice, although it's down from the screen.
Here it is.
A series of ellipsis points following the paragraph.
Yeah, because it was technical, and I thought
well,
it was.
Well, I wonder what you've deleted from the original letter.
He says that you assume a minimum of entropy at the lowest point, for which there's no rationalization in the papers and within the context of the model given, and therefore he finds them unpleasant.
Could it have been something like this?
Here it is.
You can evade the theorem by postulating that the universe was contracting prior to some time. This sounds as if there's nothing wrong with having a contraction prior to expansion. But the problem is that a contracting universe is highly unstable. Small perturbations would cause it to develop all sorts of messy singularities, so that it would never make it to the expanding phase.
Now, and then Krauss just stutters on and on and on. But as you can see, he just wasn't honest, and he manipulated the document. He took out parts of the quote, and Craig was being honest, giving the whole quote, and it was Woody Allen over here on the right that wasn't honest. But let's listen to the crowd roar again when Krauss is... caught in a lie. Check it out.
Eternal, and that they involve, therefore, a beginning of the universe,
Bill,
just like the
you
others.
You can do the math if you want.
I couldn't help notice, although it's down from the screen now, that there was a series of ellipsis points following the paragraph.
Yeah, because it was technical, and I thought
well,
it was...
Well, I wonder what you've deleted from the original letter.
Lawrence Krauss, you should be ashamed of yourself, man. This is just, this is why, if you guys do a search on the internet, it'll say atheists are now the least trusted minority in society. Just quote the truth. Don't be dishonest. Be an honest atheist. Anyways, you guys got to see this entire video of this debate. It's a long debate, but it's an hour and 46 minutes. Go to shotgunnow.net, go to our videos section, and I think that Lawrence Krauss is going to be having nightmares over this debate for a long, long time.